Hello, fellow survivors, and I took a day off from the last time to just scope up a little bit and cap up my levels, do a little bit of grinding, get ready for this, and then on our way in, as we were exploring the map a little bit, and doing a little bit of exploration, we found this military camp right here. And in this military camp, we found a 177 sniper rifle. Ain't that awesome? I am sorry that I wasn't able to show you all of the many times I exploded myself on landmines trying to clear this out with only 12 arrows. I thought I was recording, and either I recorded incorrectly or the file got corrupted, because that video, unfortunately, is not going to be today's video. But instead, for today's video, we are going to... Wait, what? Oh, do we go for an airdrop to the west, or that's to the southwest? That's kind of almost sort of in the same direction. So let's try and head for that airdrop with a completely full inventory, because that certainly won't be frustrating or anything. Keeping an eye out for dogs, because keeping an eye out for dogs is something that we do. I gotta tell you though, side effects of building in the wasteland. There's a dog. I totally did not realize just how many scattered cars were in the wasteland in Alpha 16. It looks like it is more than was in 15. And that means we will have engines and automotive parts galore. So that's going to make our final project a lot easier. Also, these things are almost impossible to come by. Put you in there for a second. Do the swap. Turn you into arrows. Pick you back up. Okay. Now, before I touch that thing, I want to make really sure. Oh, nice pool of water. I want to make really sure that the scene is safe, because I'm going to need to do a couple minutes of thinking, and I don't want that sucker sneaking up on me while I'm doing that. Come on, figure out your line. I don't have all day. Really? Derpiest dog ever. How about if I get closer? Does that help you out? If I miss repeatedly, does that help you out? Derpy dog. Oh, now I have your attention. You should totally be dead by now. All right, so let's hope we've got an antibiotic in that box. Okay. Now we should be clear. Oh, look, antibiotic. We'll just use that right now. We will read that, and then we will read it again for some reason. And then I just need to find two slots. Two slots, two slots. Oh, I guess I'm gonna scrap you. Beakers. I am desperately in need of a cooking pot, because if I had a cooking pot, this would make this decision so much easier. Can I drink both of you? I believe I can. Which makes it a non-decision. All right, and now we head to the trader. Okay, so we made it out of that biome, and none too soon. The wasteland is definitely treacherous, although I am enjoying it. I mean, it's a step up. I will be okay with it once I get a little bit more gear. So I think that this build idea is going to be fun. I just need to get some more stuff first, because let me tell you, that is nerve-wracking. And those dogs, they come out of nowhere, just like deer. Although, unlike deer, the dogs are not tasty. But the dogs do serve one purpose. I mean, the deer helps with that as well. But if you notice, we already have 37 hide. That means I am a couple lead pipes away from being able to start my base and drop a pair of forges in it right from the start. So really, at this point, all I need is two pipes or a wrench, and we are good to go. I know that I did have a wrench in the last video, but I died it and lost my bag and couldn't find it, which is a shame, because that 179 wrench right now is really the only thing we need to get ourselves up and running. While we are in this biome, we will make avid use of the coal deposits, and that also means that it is likely that we will probably base in the here-ish area. That way we have access to coal and access to nitrate, and that means we can basically go mining for gunpowder if we so choose. My heart rate can calm down now. Seriously, running around in the wasteland, you know, I don't recommend it if you have a heart condition, but if you're heartless like me, it's actually a lot of fun. Couple more hits with the beat up dying stone axe. There we go. Okay. Looks like another POI over there. That'll be fun. Oh, and then we got a camp here, and we might as well go through this real quick. What you got? Drink a drink. Eat. A little lunch break, you know, while the zombies get closer. Ta-da! Wait. A little screen lock there. But it's all good. We're all fine here now. Thank you. How are you? You're dead. That's how you are. Keep a nasty sandwich. I should probably wear those. Scrap those. I will read the hunting rifle schematic so that I can repair our hunting rifle should we find more hunting rifle parts. This is the hunting rifle map, apparently. Cowboy hat is a whole lot and not really useful to me at the moment. More lead. Lead is good. I have a cooking pot. I don't want to pick up any more cooking pots, lest cooking pots explode. We will scrap you. We will wear these nice cloth gloves in place of my crappy plant fiber ones. The pistol receiver is going to wait there, because we're going to just use that as a drop bag for anything that we're going to keep that we're not going to sell to the trader, which means I might as well give myself some searching slots for things that I know that I'm going to be bringing with me. I will have a lot more slots once we get done at the trader, because I'm going to be selling a whole lot of this stuff. I guess no reason to keep getting hunted at the moment. Okay, that was a lot less effective than I expected. Two slots. Two things that I know that I want to keep that I'm not selling. Put that there. We'll put that there. We will come back for them in a mo. We will keep collecting feathers, because since I'm expecting screen lock, since I'm expecting to have a forge set up soon, I think that the 116 arrows I have are probably going to last me until I have the forge set up, and that means that all these other feathers I'm collecting will become iron-headed arrows, and that just suits me just fine. You know, that's going to be one of those things that's going to make surviving with the in the wasteland a lot easier, is having arrows that do more damage. Okay, you know what? I don't want to complain, because I really like the fact that there are traders in the game. I do, however, keep running into the problem that the only one that I ever find is Trader Bob. Check Trader Bob's trash, see if he has anything in his trash that he is interested in buying. There's going to be a lot of oil on the outside once we come back around. Auger blade. Well, I'm not selling you, so you can wait there. Drink. Okay. That big blue car. I know that I'm not selling bullets and shells and magnum parts, because it is my most favoritest gun in the game. Or beakers, or feathers, or cloth, or lumps of clay, or raw meat, or cooking pots. Okay, so now we will remember to head back to the blue car. You guys are going to remind me if I forget. I know that you will. Our comment screen will light up. With the second class elitist, you dropped all that stuff in the car and forgot to go back to pick it up. Oh, there's one pipe. One pipe down, three pipes to go. Pipes should not be difficult to come by. Interesting road surface. Hello, cactus. Feeling like there's all these people that tried making it to the trader and died, like, right outside. I probably shouldn't ransack his goods, but we're gonna. Give me a wrench. All the zombies be- Yes, wrench! Oh my god, and it's a big wrench, and that's gonna be awesome! And there will be so much wrenching of the things. Not in here, obviously, but... upstairs. Okay, so... Oh, let's close the door. And where is our free XP? I hear our free XP. Shovel. It's really low quality. We're just going to scrap it because I don't think he's going to buy it worth anything anyway. Clothing he'll buy. Something bad for the animal hide. And the wrench, because if, as long as I put that wrench there, there is no way I'm going to forget to come back in for the wrench. So the idea from what I've been told is eventually, like, you're going to be able to rent these places to have, like, a safe zone to crash in overnight if you don't have a base location, which is kind of cool. See if any of them have desks or things. Somebody else beating on this thing. Of course it's a crawler. Crawlers have got to be the most annoying part of the apocalypse. Did I leave anything new? Probably not. Alright, 6:30, we're kinda starting to run out of time, so let's go talk to Trader Bob. I've been told there are other traders. I've run into Hugh once and Bob like 35,000 times. Still have yet to meet Joel.
You need assistance?
Do I need assistance? I need you to buy stuff. Sell that. Sell those. Sell that. Sell that. Sell that. Sell that. Sell those. Sell those. Sell. Sell. So, you got a lot of noise outside. You want me to take care of that for you, Bob?
You come back sometime.
I'll come back as soon as I have more stuff from these guys out here. Stop bouncing. You're impossible to get a critical on when you bounce. There we go. Is this like a day horde? Seems to be a lot of zombies appearing around this place that's not supposed to have zombies. I guess my theory about people not quite making it to the traders is being proven correct. Come here, fat man. Good night, Edgar. Ta-da! Wow, and we still can't carry all of our stuff. That is several flavors of insane. Got this? I'm experiencing stage 2 heat stroke. Whoa! Yes, I was. Well, that'll teach me to not pay attention. The good news is our bag is safe. The good news is we know exactly where our bag is. The bad news is we've got to go all the F down there to get it again. That was a super dumb death. Super, super, super dumb. I'm just not watching my conditions. Oh look, a backpack. You're not gonna fit. I'm gonna just... Well, we're going to wear this, because all this is getting worn. Which is going to add to our heat problem again, I know. But I will be more diligent this time, I promise. Mostly in that I cannot get less diligent than not. They're going to go... they're just going to go there. That is going to make a duct tape, so that's going to free up that slot. You're going to go away. Medicines go there. You're going to stack. You go in your assigned position. Wow, I have over 250 arrows, feathers. That is awesome. Else is not gonna fit. Grr. Bob, you need to buy some more of my junk. You have more zombies outside. Seriously, do you not like have defenses? Using that. Alright, so let me see what you got for sale that I might be interested in. Short iron pipe. You know what? I shouldn't do it this way. But I'm gonna, because I got the money, and now I don't need to worry about it. NATO rounds. Since I've got a NATO gun, and I've got the money to burn, I might just pick those up. The reinforced steel upgrade is amazing. Anvils would be silly to buy. A sink. I wanted a sink on my other game so badly, never had one for sale. That and, you know, run NPCs really wanted the shop sign. Alright, let's see what's in the secret stash. Pistole, feathers, heavy bandit boots. Oh, mining helmet. If I could afford the mining helmet, I would buy it just so we had it to start off. But I can't, so I won't. So... that looks like that's going to be that. We're going to use that. Not that it matters with the rate at which we keep deceasing ourselves. Can't believe that I'm going to leave here still with too many things to fit in inventory. Whoa! Pay more attention. Cactus? Do I hear one more knocking around out here? Apparently, I do not. Oh, and then we have the stuff that we wanted to pick up when we came back out. There is somebody else out here. Got this? For the empty bottle, nurse. That's not medical supplies. Alright, so we're gonna get rid of you. We're gonna get rid of you. We're gonna pick up the rest of our stuff, and we're finally gonna be on the way, so... we're going to be ending this episode here. I want to thank you very much for watching my shenaniganry. If you enjoyed it, please hit that like button for me. Hit it a lot. Just make sure you hit it an even number of times because an make sure you hit it an odd number of times because an even number of times is absolutely useless. Also, if you have not yet done so, please subscribe if you would like to see more of my shenaniganry. If you're interested in Alien and Matt Damon-esque shenaniganry, please check out my Osiris New Dawn gameplay. If you are interested in human-on-human shenaniganry, please check out my Subsistence. And if you're interested in dinosaur shenaniganry, which just sounds weird, please check out my new Ark gameplays. So, thank you very much. Hope you find a safe place to bed down. I hope the zombies don't get you, and I will see you in the morning.